Morning's meditation. Glad everybody here. It's really nice hearing Swami Muktananda chanting the Shiva Aratri. And it's really so great, all these great metaphors of consciousness. Shiva, pure awareness, primordial awareness. Dharmakaya, primordial awareness. Manifesting the Shakti, Sambhogakaya, the apparitional manifestations. and the Shakti as the manifestation of appearances, us, the Manakaya. So we'll suspend our mind just a little bit. And as we suspend our mind just a little bit, then we can free awareness from simply being located completely in the mind, or even a particular function of the mind, like having this great eagle in a tiny, tiny cage. So we open the door a bit. And release awareness. And we focus awareness within awareness. And the object of awareness becomes her own self. And rather than being located in the mind, we feel ourselves located more and more in the body, Embodying awareness, embodying consciousness. And so awareness becomes the enlivener, and the illuminator of our body, radiating through the inner yin meeting the outer yin, as it's described in the Yeshe Lama. So we'll do that. We'll focus. And a very open focus. Unbound focus. And what makes it easier when we meditate like in a group, if two other people are entering awareness, there'll be a pull that helps us go more easily into awareness itself. As people, we can transfer all sorts of things to each other, All sorts of affects, good, bad, and different. But it's so wonderful that we can also bring forth the experience of awareness within each other, out of resonance, out of transmission. There's Bodhidharma, great master who brought Zen to Japan, China, would say there's a transmission beyond words and letters that does not belong to any tradition whatsoever. It's the very nature of human awareness. That is the Buddha. So as you and I enter awareness together, the natural transmission of awareness takes place. And besides such transmission happening naturally, we can also extend it. Because we discover, as we become aware of awareness, that awareness is not the mind, it's not a thought, it's not a sensation, it's not a feeling, though you can have lots of feelings about it, it's not memory. It's its own thing. So we begin to feel the qualities opening up in us. Space, open space. And perhaps you're feeling that now. And this space is alive, huh? It's not dead space. It pulsates. It moves. There's energy. Then it's also clear. It is knowingness itself. It's light, luminous. It's very, very pure. It can hold everything, absorb everything, metabolize everything, dissolve everything. That's why it's the great protection. Actually, our minds can only do so much. Then they collapse. So from the very beginning, we learn how to extend our awareness. Or as the great Dzogchen master, Dzogchen Rinpoche, would say, extension is the secret. So we've established ourselves in awareness, so now we're going to extend. There's no effort in extension. It's not a straining moment, but we'll simply extend through the body. It's a very subtle intention. Sort of intending, but not quite intending. Wishing, but not quite wishing. So extend through the body, all the way up and all the way down, vertically. It's sort of like moving your forefinger. You know, you can do it. You learned how to do it. But actually, you don't really know how to do it. You just do it. So extend all the way down, awakening awareness in the body, awakening the centers, and then extend all the way up. Palate of the mouth, eyes, top of the head. Begin to feel the column of energy and light. Extend to the very tips of our fingers and toes, embodying awareness. Embodying awareness. Actually, the entire process of realization is the embodying of awareness. Embodying our mind into the awareness field. Embodying our situations into this awareness. And then, having situated ourselves within the body, we'll extend to each other. We extend to the immediacy of our situation. That's the true mandala, huh? That's the true mandala. The immediacy of our situation unfolding over and over and over again. So as we extend to the immediacy of our situation, the field expands. Bigger is better. And the essence of the path of Dzogchen Mahamudra is the path of being in awareness in whatever is happening. So in this way, our very life events, our karma, is the path of realization, just as it is. So we don't really have to move and go anyplace, even if we do. We're in that unfolding, the being in awareness, extended field, experiencing whatever is being experienced in the awareness field is the path of natural liberation. Let's extend again to each other and to our friends on the internet. And this capacity to extend gives us stability. Huh? It helps us integrate our mind. So we start to integrate almost immediately our mind, our body, into this awareness. So then we're going to make our next extension to our ancestors, the generational field, because you and I are expressions and extensions, manifestations of the generational field. So in gratitude, we extend to them. We extend the light to the light. We extend awareness to awareness. It's always the same practice, extending awareness to awareness. The inner awareness meets the outer awareness, and oneness arises. Then we'll extend to the great teachers and yogis we've met, both personally and through others. We extend to the great teachers, various traditions. Huh? When we extend in a quality consciousness. With each extension, if things are working, we become stronger and fuller with the light of awareness. The path of awareness is a relational path. It's the opposite of solipsism. It cuts through. Opens to the openness, which is awareness itself, not only in our own self, but everyone. Then we'll extend to the different traditions we participate in. And here we understand that all those traditions are different articulations, cultural articulations of people's experience of primordial awareness, languages and costumes, different rituals. Then finally we'll make one more extension to what's mysterious and ineffable, and that's the dimension of the apparitions, or the Sambhogakaya dimension. The dimension of the archetypical dimension, as Jung would call it, the deities, the devas, the dakinis. Huh? So we'll extend to dakini this morning. And these archetypes are metaphors and expressions of the very qualities of our own awareness. Now we're established, we can simply rest for a moment. I'm just going to talk a little bit more about this embodiment. So as you and I, just like we are right now, have, we're not just holding awareness, we've entered awareness, and we're becoming it more and more. And so this lived experience of awareness, this experience of awareness, as that takes place for us, it becomes more and more embodied. Huh? Initially, it may feel like a little spot in the center of your head. But as things move along, it becomes more and more felt, this presence, this light, this energy, throughout the entire body, but most especially in the inner heart center, in the center of our chest. And as this unfolding of the awareness field, it's an embodying unfoldment. So we don't leave the body. We really stay in the body because the body is the alchemical vase. It is the vase that holds. And within the body, by holding awareness, the body of light becomes more and more formed. What they call the Vajravas body. And as the body of light becomes more informed, then the flesh becomes, feels more luminous and more energized. And then we no longer have to hold awareness with intentionality, because actually that's very tiring. And the very body of light begins to hold awareness. Self-arisen awareness. Spontaneously arisen awareness. Naked awareness. And so, the lived experience of awareness is centered in our body. And this body opens, huh? The openness of awareness actually opens our body immediately into the world. So as the yogis say, the bliss of samadhi is the bliss of the world. So perception and the perceived are given with immediacy and oneness. Again, the inner yin meets the outer yin. The inner field meets the outer field. As you and I experience awareness, we experience the beingness of our own being, since awareness is beingness itself. And we experience this embodiedness as our very self. It is our self. It's not deep, deep down, far, far away. It is the very awareness, huh? Primordial awareness, manifest in you, in space and time, as you and me. This primordial awareness manifests in a body and in a mind, in space and time. This openness, this primordial openness. And so, this subjectivity, that's us, the I-ness, this opening, primordial awareness, the primordial openness, the Dharmakaya, Shiva, if you like, manifest in us, and also manifest in the world around us. The same openness manifesting within us and manifesting within human beings, within animals, with even the physical world. Primordial embodiment. It arises out of the flesh and out of the manifestation of the elements. So out of the pure awareness arising in Sambhogakaya is the elements. The luminosity begins to become more refined. Huh? The different elements begin to arise in all sorts of cohesive combinations, and then that manifests the element of the flesh, Nimanakaya, this world. And so that's one of the reasons why we've been practicing the elements a lot, because once we learn to hold awareness, we can take a more refined step and strengthen the light and ourself and each other. This body, your body, my body, is the field of the location. It's localization, singularization. Primordial awareness is located in me, and as you. And it's located both in time and space. I'm a little spot in time and space. I have some duration. I hope it's long. And then it dissolves and disappears back into its source. It arises in time and space. And yet, what is so wonderful, the wonder of wonders, is that you and I are both in time and space, and we're not in time and space. We're multidimensional. That's why we can be in time and space and yet experience timeless awareness, which is primordial awareness itself in this body. Let's try it for a moment. And most of the things are happening, it's really just pointing out. You can notice the timeless dimension, timeless awareness. And yet, time enters into it. There's a conjunctio, a union of timeless awareness and time. That is the essence of Dzogchen. The essence of the Mahamudra. The Dharmakaya permeates and manifests Sambhogakaya and manifests Nimanakaya. Flesh, us, earth, cars, cities, and yet that timeless awareness is us. It's located in a mind and in a body, in that continuum. And yet, timeless awareness is present. That is the great paradox of us. This timeless awareness is not dissociation. It is the complete opposite of dissociativeness. is the natural state of awareness manifesting in time. And you and I can experience timeless awareness in time, and time touching timeless awareness. That is the incarnation right there. As we have access to our own nature, which is timeless awareness manifesting, we can also experience the apparitional dimension, Sambhogakaya. We can experience the archetypical dimension. We can experience the underbelly of the flesh, of Nirmanakaya. We can experience the vortexes, the deities, the energies. So in this, these traditions of appearance and the manifestation of appearance, there's oneness between the appearances, between the apparition, and between the pure awareness itself. So in these ways, appearance is divinity itself. We're going to focus just for a moment on the elements again. Which is the manifestation of primordial awareness as the light. And we'll do it with the mantric syllables. And the mantric syllables are simply like little icons, iconic, that you utilize to open your perception to the elements. And working with the elements can strengthen our embodiment a lot. So for our purposes here, there's a lot of different ways of expressing this, but for our purposes here, we're going to focus on the top of our head for a moment. And there's a mantra, Ma. I mean, it indicates spaciousness, huh? Space. Unbound space that holds everything. Ma. It's dark, luminous darkness. Then our forehead, we'll focus on the mantra for a second. Ha. Maha. And ha is the water element. And it's white, luminous white, crystalline white. Maha. Throat. Mahari. Ri is the earth element. And all of these are considered the dakinis, because the dakinis are considered the elements. Huh? Mahari. And Ri, earth, is yellow, the yellow goddess. Huh? Ni is red, heart essence, fire. Fire. Intense. Red, Ri. Ni. Sa is at the navel. Air. Green. Ma Harinisa. So we'll just do this just for a few moments. We do Ma. You extend it through your body first. Ma. Ha. Ri. Ni. Sa. And then we're going to focus into the immediacy of our situation, which is each other. And we're going to extend the elements to each other. Ma. Ha. Ri. Ni. And we'll do it again. Ma. Ha. Ri. Ni. Sa. And then we'll do one more. Where rather than extending, you'll feel yourself releasing, like you're just releasing the elements. Ma. Ha. Ri. Ni. Sa. And release again. Ma. Ha. Ri. Ni. Sa. And there's a transmission beyond words and letters. Does not belong to any tradition. It's the very nature of human awareness itself. That is the Buddha. Or as Dzogchen Rinpoche would say occasionally, It's really best not to whine, cry, and beg for help like a beggar in the street, but take the power of the light that is yours and use it.
Ale Oh,
Traditions, great traditions of Shaivism and Dzogchen Mahamudra traditions. The deities, huh? The gods, the goddesses, Dakinis, Devas. Or the very fabric of one's own awareness, huh? And so one understands and honors, huh? The deities as the very beingness of one's own being. And so the practices, were to bring them forth, those powerful qualities, beneficent qualities. And so in these traditions, from a theistic point of view, the entire world is divinity. And also, we'll be ending soon. when one has the capacity of awareness and it's awakening in you, sometimes in the very opening of it, there's a great sensitivity. You have this great space of awareness, but it's a bit thin, it feels like. That's why practices like the elements can strengthen your awareness field. The great protection is a strong, powerful shakti, awareness field. Then you'll feel less impinged upon by circumstances. With that understanding, let's extend to each other one more time. Been cultivating awareness for quite some. We're going to extend to each other, but we're also going to extend to people we know and love, maybe having difficulties. We'll extend to them. Direct, unmediated, inside to inside. Then we'll extend to each other. In Qigong, the gong is the power of extension. With that, we can rub our hands together. We can place it in our heart, and all the different traditions have some form of sealing. And sealing is not so much locking it in there, but it helps us sustain it. We can place it on our navel, dantian, even our throat today, and our forehead and top of our head, since we've been using those centers. I'd like to thank everybody for coming today. And also, next week, Saturday, not this week, but I think it's the 15th, is it, on Saturday, from 9 to 5 on Saturday, and from Sunday from 9 to 12, we're having Lama Lena Farrell come here, and she has been the translator for many, many years of Lama Wandor, who is this great, wonderful Dzogchen master who has been coming here and has brought us so much a stream of energy and light. And he's actually ill now, and he's getting very old, so he's given her the teaching lineage. So it's really quite wonderful and unusual in the Tibetan world. Tends to be rather patriarchal. You have a woman who's now carrying this powerful lineage. So please come. There's no cost. You can make a donation. And she's a very great person. And she's also very funny and a character. And she has a master of language. And her capacity to articulate understanding in the text is quite, quite wonderful. And the text that she's going to be talking from and transmitting from, the empowerments, will be a text by Padmasambhava, the primordial guru of Dzogchen Mahamudra. And it's called Self-Arising Awareness, it's Spontaneity and Nakedness. Because as we all know, skillful means only goes so far, and it's quite secondary to the arising, the spontaneous arising of this light of awareness in our bodies and around us. So please come to that if you can. Now, the only problem is we're really getting super filled up. And we'd rather have people we know than those we don't know come. It's the way it is, right? So if you want to come, please email us, okay? And you should do it today, because we're starting to top out. Then we're going to say no more, okay? But why don't you get, if you want to come, email us, and that way we can get you on the list. It's the best way to do that. Thank you all so much. Sharon, do you have any announcements, son? Thank you, guys. You're welcome to stay and meditate to 9 o'clock, and then also we'll have some refreshments. Thank you. And then also next week, if you can help out, anybody's free to help out on Saturday. That would really be great, like just to help people sit down and registration, stuff like that. It'd be great. Thank you all. Which is really great. Thanks. Ala de na ke are lo e kolore ya mengend trope are lo e shingom ne ya parin zin de pe mo are lo e thre zaya are trope.